Hey, this is Ashley, and you guys are watching Ashley Epidemic, and I'm here to talk a little bit about New East and the fact that New East has renewed their contract with Pledis, which I am so excited about because that means there's going to be more New East. But also, this is a long road coming. There was a period of time when it seemed like this event seemed like it was a near impossibility, considering the track record and the things that had happened to New East. And in case you don't know what I'm talking about, let me just go ahead and rewind a bit and give you a little bit of info and why I'm so happy that it has actually finally come to this. So let's give a little bit of basics. So New East is a 5-member group. It includes the leader, JR, who was born Kim Jong-hyun on June 8th, 1995. Next is Aaron, who was born Aaron Kwok, is an LA boy, in fact, and was born May 21st, 1993. We have the lovely, lovely Baekho, who was born Kang Dong-ho on July 21st, 1995, and I just love him. There was Min-hyun, who was born Hwang Min-hyun on August 9th, 1995. And last, but certainly not least, is my bias, Rin, who was born Che Min-ki on November 3rd, 1995. And those are the 5 members of New East. Together, they debuted on March 15th, 2012 with the title track, Face. And they did start with a bang, but what happened was they quickly started to lose interest. And what happened was that Face got a lot of attention, but then each subsequent release got less and less, which is unfortunate because their music was just getting stronger and stronger. Unfortunately, you just can't control the public. Into New East, not long after I got into K-pop, their sound instantly pulled me in. And I just was instantly in love with the song that was out that had just been released at that time, which was Overcome. And I loved it. So much so that I decided that I was going to buy their very next album, which happened to be Canvas. So yes, I have a very old version of Canvas and I absolutely love it. In fact, I just love New East music in general. But that's not what I'm really here to talk about. Their music was strong, and like the meaning of New East's name, they had this strong established sound that they knew how to do well. They were just being overlooked. Add in the fact that their company wasn't treating them the best. They were being sent on a lot of overseas trips and promotions, which, yes, overseas promotions help, but they were getting no time to actually promote in their home country, which at the end of the day is extremely important. There were events and incidents where members were told that they had to get to an event, but they had to go do it themselves. They had to hop a cab by themselves without a manager. There were numerous incidents of various things where these idols were just not being treated properly. It's not that an idol can't get to and figure out how to get someplace themselves, but it's the fact that they're arriving to an actual event completely alone, which is a little bit concerning. There was even an entire fan-made documentary about how New East was mistreated and how the progression of their careers had come to be where it was, where that they were a 4-year group and they were struggling so badly. It came to the point where their company was overlooking them, but not so much the fact that they weren't afraid of the possible disbandment. Essentially, they were given a choice that they would either be forced to disband at the end of their contracts, or they could go do something called Produce 101. Now, at the time, Produce 101 had a all-girl version, and that's it. Produce 101 was coming back for its second run-through, and it was going to be a guy version, and they were allowing people that were in groups that hadn't maybe been so successful go on this show and participate with brand new regular trainees as well. This happened for a number of groups, and New East thankfully, did well. Fans, loves, rallied behind the guys, as did clearly many people who didn't even know anything about New East, rallied behind them, and they were receiving votes. What happened with Produce 101 is that 4 of the 5 members ended up going on the show. And from that, 3 of them got extremely far into the process. Actually, let's modify that. 4 of them got very far, but 3 of them stood an actual potential chance of joining the actual final group. In the end, only Minhyun made it into the group, and only JR was a hair close to making it in. But at the end of the day, that actually worked out in their favor. See, what Produce 101 did was it brought attention to New East. All of a sudden, people that had no idea who New East were joining in and trying to support New East. And even people who maybe didn't understand or see that some of the members maybe didn't make it through, the fact that Minhyun was still a part of New East and never disconnected or never broke any ties with New East meant that even if they came in well after and liked 101 and they liked Minhyun, that gave them an instant tie to New East, because when 101 was done, Minhyun was going back to New East. In the meantime, New East had this opportunity to ride their success and promote more. So New East did go forward as New East W. This was New East with the 4 members that were remaining. So we had Aaron, Baekho, Rin, and JR. And together they continued as New East W while Minhyun was off doing 101 things, which worked out perfectly because this allowed New East W to promote and gain more fans and establish themselves and pretty much become a solid group in their own right, finally, after years and years. So ultimately, at the end of the day, Produce 101 really extremely helped New East W, New East as a whole, out a lot. This gave New East new life. And now with 101 over and Minhyun returning, the group is reunited as 5, and they had the opportunity, because of their new success, that they are not facing a possible disbandment anymore. Instead, they've renewed their contracts. And guess what? I'm really excited because that means I get more New East. I get New East as a whole after a couple years now, and it's going to be amazing. I hope that other people are excited to see New East going forward, and that now that 101 has disbanded, that the hype isn't going to fade down too much, and that New East can continue to be a solid group because they deserve it. They're really good, and they're finally getting a chance to finally shine. And yeah, let me know what you think of New East in the comments down below. If you started liking New East, let me know when you did. And yeah, let's just go ahead and talk. Who is your bias? Who's your favorite? But if you guys like this video, please make sure you like it. If you'd like to see more reactions from me, make sure that you subscribe. Bye.